Welcome back to Claremore High School football. We're in overtime. Sorry we had more technical difficulties. Those things just happen. But here's what happens at the end of the fourth quarter. Pryor ended up advancing the ball to about midfield and then turned it over there as the clock ran out. Pryor won the toss for the overtime and elected to play defense first. Overtime rules in Oklahoma High School football. Both teams will have an opportunity from the 10-yard line. And if they're tied after the first overtime, they turn around and the team that had the ball first will be on defense first. Claremore, first and 10, first and goal from the 10. Cutsinger hands the ball off to Coronado and he picks up maybe two.
He runs into the pulling guard. They got one going off. He's hurt.
Brings up second down and eight. Second down and goal from the eight, I guess, is how you say that.
I definitely take my chances with Brooke Sherrill in the corner at the top and not split Brooke out quite as wide. He was off about 7 yards. Now Brooke's not split out this time. We got
little
tight
bunch
trips.
Formation, yeah. Right. Oh.
Well, we fumbled the ball.
We fumbled that reverse to Sherrill. And he's looking for the end zone. Brooksy flies through the air. Touchdown,
yeah.
Claremore. Brooke Sherrill.
No flags.
There we go. Claremore scores first. Hunter Woods in, coming in to attempt the extra point. Big play right there. Brooke Sherrill got outside, kind of jumped through the air, holding the ball out with his right hand. And it was Hunter Woods in to attempt the extra point. Snaps back, kick is up, and the Hunter Wood extra point is good. Claremore scores 7 points in their overtime possession. Pryor now gets it four times. The thing about it is Pryor has four downs. They'll be trying to score a touchdown all four times, Coach.
Well, we need to make sure that we contain him to his left because he's going to roll to his left. He's not going to roll right. They haven't rolled right all night. So we need to make sure we bring pressure off the edge to the quarterback's left side.
Big play here. You got an updated score from Sepulpa?
23-20.
How much? Fourth quarter?
Fourth quarter. I don't have the time. There's 7 minutes left in the fourth quarter.
All right, here we go. Pryor taking over first and goal from the 10-yard line. Two receivers tight. Right. Too tight. They're going to run it.
Different
high
quarterback.
Snap. 28. That's Ballou. Direct snap to Ballou.
Keel Penn
is right there. And big 5-yard loss. Keel Penn ran him down. He has to go out. Ballou has to go out. Lost his helmet. He's got to go out for this play.
We need to make sure we contain him to his left side here.
Now, what Claremore doesn't need to do, what happens in a penalty in overtime? Do you get a new set of downs? Is it an automatic first down?
Depends on what the penalty is.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, that makes sense.
You know, personal foul. But right here, we need to make sure we bring somebody off the edge and make sure we contain them.
Here we go. Big second down right here.
Somebody's coming off the sidelines.
Pryor calling a timeout. Wow, it's a good game. Claremore Pryor always good. I don't think I ever lost to Pryor. Maybe once. Coach, we were 9-0. Played Pryor the last game of the season. Mud Bowl, right here at Lanto Field. They beat us. What was the score, Picks? 3-0.
Would you think it'd be a different outcome if you played on turf?
Oh, yeah.
Huh?
Yes.
Well, they were running. They were playing the same conditions you were, right?
Yeah, but they didn't have the speed we did.
Oh. It negated the speed.
6 inches of rain that day.
You know, when I was
in today's world, they would have. They'd have canceled it.
Hey, when I was in eighth grade, we played BA Central.
Yeah.
6 inches of rain.
How'd you do? Did you whoop them?
We won 6-0.
There you go. Did you score the touchdown?
1 yard quarterback sneak.
You?
Yeah.
You were the quarterback?
Yeah.
Was your mom the teacher?
No, she wasn't.
All right.
I played quarterback in junior high in my sophomore year. I was a sophomore JV quarterback.
I think people just fell out of their chairs right now at home listening, thinking about you.
Sophomore JV quarterback.
There you go. Here we go. Second down and 16 upcoming for the Tigers. And he drops back to pass.
No, we're not containing him to his left.
Oh, he throws it. He's
That's out of the end zone.
Oh, they called a touchdown.
Here's the play of the ball game. Why don't we contain him to his left? We give him time. Left-handed people only understand that. Bring pressure from his left.
Hey, Pryor's going for two. They don't kick it. They're trying to win it right here. Well, here's the play of the game.
And they're
going to
come from his left side.
Contain him from his left.
I had to yell to the coaches down there a couple blocks down.
Claremore's going to call timeout, I think.
Okay, yeah, we got like four.
Claremore leads 21-20. Play of the game right here. I don't know if it's play of the game. It's a pretty important one.
Well, they're going to go for two. They're either going to get it or not, so we're probably not going to go for second overtime. I don't know if he was in. Was he in?
He was in. Apparently we have confirmation that he did catch it inbounds.
Barely.
You know, and we had like plenty of time to react on the ball. It was just a good throw and a good catch. You know, we know which way he's going to roll. He's thrown everything rolling to his left. Not that I want to beat a dead horse.
Well, but, you hear that horse is showing some blood right now, Coach. Yeah. I can tell you.
Well, after this play, one side's going to be happy and one side's going to be sad. And
all I can say to the Claremore kids is tomorrow morning, no matter what happens, those Pryor kids are going to wake up and they're going to be in Pryor. And
yeah.
So there you go. That's here true. We go. Play of the game. Direct snap.
Reverse.
And he's going to
we
waltz
got clipped.
In.
We got clipped.
No flag. There's flag, all kinds of flags.
It's not going to matter because the game's over. Was it on us? I saw a clip. Look at them. Not very.
They're happy, Coach. They came back.
Yeah. They played hard.
Talking. Oh, they're gonna have it on the Claremore 50-yard line. They're right there on the zebra where they're gonna celebrate.
Well, I know we beat them 5 years in a row, so you know every blind squirrel finds a nut every once in a while.
And again, Coach, tomorrow morning when they wake up, they're still going to be in Pryor.
Yes, sir.
So, final score, Pryor 22, Claremore 21. We'll be back. We're going to be on the road. We're in the playoffs next week, probably at Shawnee. We'll bring you all that action. For Coach Dave Garuk, Dave Jones saying good night.
Fire fans to go off the east end of the stadium. East end, please. Fans, we're going to ask everyone who needs to leave to be heading out of the stands and the stadium so we can get ready for tonight's blow show. Thank you. turn out the lights. So if you're needing to exit the stadium, please head that way now. We're going to have lights off in 30 seconds. Lights off in 30 seconds. It gives us great pleasure to bring to you the CHS Famous Glow Show.